We're under the helm with Chiefs wide receiver Jerheme Urban. Jerheme, back on the practice field after missing all of 2010 because of injury.
That's right.
I had a great training camp, and you're asked plenty of times about what it's like to be back. I'm not going to ask you that. I'm going to ask you, what is it like to be finally game planning for an opponent again?
Oh, it feels great. You know, like we've covered many times, Coach allowed me to stay in the building last year and be a part of the meeting room. So, you know, the game planning from that aspect last year is totally different than this year. It's fun, it's exciting, out there sweating with the guys. So really looking forward to September 11th.
This preseason didn't generate a lot of wins, but we entered this game. A lot of guys are confident where you guys are and being ready to play. What are some of the things that maybe the fans didn't see that got this team prepared to play football on Sunday?
Well, I think that the coaches came into this camp with a great plan. As players, we have to look at the experience on our coaching staff and trust them. You know, we had a lot of time with Coach Clark and Coach Salazar in the weight room, and our whole focus was to get ready for September 11th. And obviously, we wish we could have come out of preseason with a few wins, but at the same time, our focus was on September 11th. We believe in the plan that Coach Haley laid out in front of us, and we're ready to kick this thing off.
That was a different approach from Coach Haley and from the team. Following a very unprecedented offseason, what did you do to prepare yourself away from Arrowhead this past summer?
Well, it was a hot year down in San Antonio. I knew it was going to be hot in St. Joe, so I had a great group of guys down there at Trinity University who were working hard all summer. You know, we were on the field 5 days a week, lifting 4 days a week, and there was really no offseason for me. I was eager to go. I was healthy coming out of the season, so to speak, so I was able to kind of put two offseason programs into one and really do some hill running and just get ready to go.
Trinity University, D3, your alma mater. Your father's a football coach. You're working out with those athletes down there. Any post-playing, aspirations of being a coach?
Yeah, I'd love to coach if that situation presents itself. But right now, I'm hopefully a few years away from that. And I'd love to, you know, continue to make an impact on the field here for the Chiefs and stay here for a while.
Jerheme, this weekend, a very emotional weekend for a lot of people, the 10th year anniversary of September 11th and those attacks. What about you? Where were you on that day when you first found out about those attacks?
Yeah, I was a junior at Trinity, getting ready for the first day of class, I think, or, you know, somewhere in there. It was early in school, and my dad called me at 7 a.m. and told me to turn on the news, and my roommate and I turned on the channel, and the first tower had been under attack, and the second tower was getting ready to be attacked as well. So it was very, you know, I was old enough to where it made an impact on me. And classes were canceled. It was a day of mourning, a day of uncertainty at our school, just like the rest of the country. So, you know, I remember it vividly, and there will be a special memory for me, you know, since this is the 10th year anniversary.
It seems everyone is saying they have the best unlimited plan. Here's the truth. AT&T and Verizon give you unlimited text and talk, but charge you extra for going over 2 gigabytes of data. T-Mobile claims they're unlimited, but use your phone a lot, and they slow down your data speed. With Sprint, you don't get charged extra, you don't slow down, and you get unlimited data, text, and calling to any mobile for only $79.99. The best unlimited plan wins.